would have been the second where I pushed them quickly forward and say, look, buddy, I really need you to maintain this activity behind me. Yeah? Good, not swallowing, not swallowing, not swallowing. Well done. Sooner or don't wait too long. Yeah? Make it a little bit bigger out there and just ask maybe for a half spoon carry or three quarter. Yeah? And you still be a touch firm about those moments when he resists. That's good enough. And out. And go. Great. For the next flying change, take your time. You need to decide if he's loose enough, supple enough, and then we do the change. Take your time, take your time. Yes, suppling on the left. Rain makes perfect sense. Good, okay. Circle, elasticity, suppleness. That's right. Okay, and the shooting period on this side. Once again, most important is that he maintains the activity. Yeah, the rhythm is assured, it keeps a good CP canter, we don't have to worry about that so much, but and it's a little too small. You want to write this a little bit bigger and clearly assure this trapezia idea that the inner hind leg is clearly the center of the pyramid, okay? Make it bigger and ask the shoulders to stay a little bit to the outside and bring the haunches more in. So, yes. Good. Now go a few strides, straight ahead a little bit, Xavier, straight ahead. Good. That's it. And go from perfect, crazy to left. That's great. Go from there into a parallel again. Keep stopping the shoulders, keep the hind legs turned. Great. Very good. Out of it, Xavier again. Good. And give them a break. Good. And there we go. A little bit behind. Not to teach him necessarily a PF, but this whole idea of coming back, coming under, loosening the top line moment. That's right. Good. And a moment more. Yeah, and you can finish later on with a couple of half passes in trot. Yeah, but for now we give him a quick break. And I just want to talk about this moment right here a little bit more. It is such a huge luxury for a young horse to offer this idea that they naturally have a tendency to come underneath themselves. Yeah? So when we brought him back in canter, we could clearly see the engagement behind. What does it really mean to engage a horse? It's not just the hawk. Everybody is always so focused just on the hawk action. It's the cycle and the hip as well. Yeah? And when we can address all three joints with this moment of collection, it gives us such a perfect training tool to teach the horse, look, I need you to come back to me, I need you to bring the hind legs under, and at the same time, I'm going to teach you just a touch more suppleness to the top line, and we've got it made for, at least for the pre-St. George and the high one level. Yeah? But when this is accomplished, it's certainly a very, very good training tool. When I increase the engagement of a horse in trot and canter, I always look for an equal amount of suppleness throughout. Yeah? Too many horses are taught to be forced almost into this engagement. Yeah? And I like to use movements like the canter pyramid, like the half steps, the piaf, yeah, to teach the horse the engagement. Yeah, too many times it's done with just too much force, where the rider uses a ton of leg, a ton of pressure from the rein, and yes, you know, the horse might give a little bit at that time, it might come under, but it's not the right message that we're bringing across. Yeah? It should be done as easily as it was done here with the Hendrix horse, that we can increase the engagement and match that engagement with suppleness. That's what it's all about. Then we can really ride the movements with the proper expression and have our horses still reliable and positive about the